DevOps adoption is widespread and results in improved efficiency in any organization's IT operations as it automates the agile methodology. Let's take a look at how continuous integration and continuous deployment practice can be set up in your data integration projects with Stambia. Stambia Data Integration Solution provides three components. First, Stambia Designer, which is based on Eclipse and stores the source code in XML format. The designer can be easily installed on any operating system with a simple decompression of an archive directory. Using the designer in projects, users create three objects: metadata, mapping, and process. In the designer, plug in and use any standard source control or versioning system to manage the version of these objects. Second is Stambia Runtime, a Java component that saves the session logs in a database. Stambia Runtime is hybrid, as it can be placed on-premise, on cloud, and can also be containerized. And the third component is Stambia Production Analytics. This is a web interface used for operational activities and needs a web server. Production analytics can be on cloud, can be containerized, or called externally through APIs. Now let's take a look at how these fit in the integration architecture. While users create designs using the designer and manage the versioning and sharing using a versioning server, they can then test their designs on a local development runtime and launch executions on source and targets. The designs then can be deployed on production runtime using Production Analytics web interface. In a typical deployment, the final versions of the designs are packaged and using Production Analytics UI, Production Analytics APIs, or via command line, the executable is created with the environment-specific configurations, which is then deployed on the runtime. The APIs and command line capabilities enable the use of any external DevOps tools. Using these DevOps tools, users can set up continuous integration and continuous deployment pipelines. This automates the entire operational process, like package, build, and deploy, and speeds up deliveries to serve your customers better. Let's take a look at a small demo. Here, on a Windows machine, we have Stambia Designer, Git, and Docker installed. On Docker, we create and run containers for dev, test, and prod, runtimes, production analytics, MySQL, and Jenkins. The CI/CD pipeline will be created by using Jenkins integrated with GitHub. In Stambia Designer, we have an existing project with the Git plugin installed to push changes to the GitHub repository. We can optionally create a webhook to trigger the Jenkins job based on an event. Now, we create a Docker Compose file to have the MySQL, production analytics, all the runtimes, and Jenkins environments specified. Using the Docker Compose up, we will start all the containers and verify all are up and running. On the Jenkins dashboard, we create a pipeline job that is configured to execute a set of command line operations and call production analytics APIs to perform deployment. And finally, let's take a look at production analytics, where we have added the runtimes on development, test, and production containers with empty repositories. As well, the delivery project has no deployment at the moment. Let's make a small change to a process that is to be published as a web service. Inside the process, we open the mapping and modify the output of the web service to add company name. Now, this change can be pushed to the GitHub repository. This kicks in the CI/CD process, and the web service gets deployed to all the runtimes. We can verify that the changes have been pushed to the GitHub. In Jenkins, the deployment job is triggered by the webhook. In the console output, we can see that the package has been successfully created, and the deployment APIs have been called, and are finished successfully. On the production analytics UI, we can refresh the delivery project and see that the process has been deployed on the three environments. The delivery on each environment can also be seen under the specific runtime repositories. In case of deploying other processes, like a data loading job, etc., these can then be scheduled to run, based on a frequency, using the scheduler in production analytics. Now, we can call the web service, from the production runtime, to check the result. External artifacts repositories can also be used for the packaging and building Docker containers, etc. Stages can be defined in Jenkins for better management of your CI/CD process. To know more, check out the article at stambia.org or contact us at stambia.com.